Ontario Finance Minister Dwight Duncan is facing a tough battle ahead as the province plans to introduce a wage freeze for 1 million public sector employees. Duncan says the freeze is necessary to help lower Ontario's ballooning $21.3 billion deficit. He's been meeting with union representatives. The freeze would affect those who work at hospitals, schools, universities, and government offices. Fred Hahn is the president of the Canadian Union of Public Employees, CUPE, in Ontario. He met with Dwight Duncan today, and he joins me now from Toronto. Hello there. Thanks for being with us.
Hi there. Thank you.
So how did that meeting go?
Well, we left with more questions than answers. It wasn't clear after the presentation that the minister and deputy minister gave what the next steps are. They said that there would be some form of consultation, but it's unclear to us what that would be.
So do you feel as though this is being imposed on you, or that there is going to be some say from the union?
Well, we asked very clearly, will the minister respect free collective bargaining, the ability for those of us to negotiate on behalf of our members and to protect public services? We're going to engage in a consultation with our members on what came out of today, and we're always willing to sit down and talk with government, but we still think that they need to make the case for why it is that this would actually help the Ontario economy.
I thought the case was pretty simple, according to Dwight Duncan. The province has a $20 billion deficit. They have to get rid of it.
Well, we have to be clear about where that deficit came from. No worker in this province, whether in the private sector or the public sector, created that deficit. And if we're going to get out of that deficit, we have to make sure that we have all parts of the economy firing. What wage constraint does is actually removes money from the economy. You know, public sector workers, many of whom make $25,000, $30,000 a year, they spend every dollar they earn at the local gas station and grocery store helping to form the backbone of local economies all across the province. Restricting consumer spending, we think, is not a good idea when we're trying to ensure that the economy is strong again.
Did Minister Duncan indicate how long this freeze would last?
Well, what he's talked to us about is a two-year period for people. The reality is that, you know, we have collective agreements that are phased at different times. It's unclear to us what this would mean. At the end of it, what we have to ask ourselves is this the right thing for the economy in Ontario? Is it fair that 11% of the folks who work in the province should be asked to, you know, bear the brunt for this? How do we actually grow the economy, create jobs? Those are the ways in which we're going to really address the deficit.
How have other provinces dealt with deficits? Have wage freezes played a part in reduction?
There's a wide range of options that other provinces have used. From our perspective, Ontario is unique in a variety of ways. We are a much larger province and have you know, much different kind of economy here. And we think that there's a real role that unions and government and business can play together. Instead of talking about how we do you know, things that are short-term and you know, around restraint, why don't we engage in a much broader discussion about how to create jobs and build and rebuild the economy of the province of Ontario? That's something our members would very much like to talk about.
Fred Hahn, great talking to you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Coming up, BP looks to a new plan to seal its well in the Gulf of Mexico.